Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to be teaching you tips for painting trees using watercolour. So without further ado, let's get straight into this video. Now before we go through an actual painting demonstration, I'm going to be showing you how to paint trees as usual. So normally when painting a tree, you need to have a brush that has a fine point so you can create your trees to be straight. Now I'm going to create a straight line on the paper and then I'm going to use a fan brush. Now this is the trick. Now you use the edge of the fan brush horizontally across the paper. Now you want to continue doing this until you get to the bottom of the tree, and as you work your way down the tree, the branches are going to get larger. Now I would use larger strokes to create larger branches. Now when applying the brush, you just want to dab the brush so you get the texture of branches. Now once you're done with painting the first tree, then you use a hairdryer to dry it out so it doesn't blend into the second tree. Now you want to continue the process for the second and third tree, starting with a straight line and then using a fan brush to create horizontal strokes, and then work your way down using larger strokes on the paper. Now when painting these first group of trees, you want to create depth and distance by creating a variety of sets of different sizes to add depth and contrast to this painting. Now before we go through the second group of trees, I want to briefly go through what values are, as in my last video I did mention that I will talk about the importance of gradients and values in your paintings. Now values are the range of darks and lights in your artwork. Now you want to have a range of values in your artwork. Now the values which are darkest are normally the most opaque, and the values which are the lightest are normally the ones which are used with more and more water. Now you want to create a variety of tones to add depth and distance to your artwork. So now that we know what gradients are, we want to apply the same knowledge to this tree painting. Now when painting the second row of trees, you want to use more colour, and I would use a bit more black to create your medium tone in your artwork. Now I would apply the same knowledge as we learned firstly, starting with a straight line and then using horizontal strokes, and then as you work your way down the tree, you would apply a bit more strokes to get a larger amount of trees. Now, as you work your way down the paper, the values will get darker and darker. Now, as I mentioned, in your painting, you want to have a variety of different tones in your artwork. You want to have light, medium, and dark tone to add contrast and depth to your artwork. Now, when you're painting the last row of trees, you want to make sure that it's the most opaque by applying a lot more color than we have previously. Now you want to apply the same technique that we learned previously, starting with a straight line, and as you work your way down, you want to use larger strokes to get a larger amount of brushes. Now, as I mentioned, you want to dab the brush instead of applying them in larger strokes to create a branch of tree. Now, as you can see, we have created an amazing painting which includes a range of darks and light tones to add depth and contrast to paintings, and including a variety of different sizes in your artwork. Now, let's apply all the methods that we have learned into a full painting demonstration of a sunset painting. Now, I have created a full tutorial of a sunset painting on my channel, so I'll leave the link in the description if you would like to check it out. But let's go through how I painted a sunset, starting with the wet and wet technique to create soft gradients of tone in your artwork, and then applying a bit of yellow on the paper, and then using darker colors like the orange and the red in your artwork. Now, when applying the wet and wet technique, you want to apply a generous amount of water. Now, you don't want to form puddles on the paper, as this will ruin your paper and you won't get great results in your paintings. Now, as I said, you want to start with the yellow and then work your way up to darker colors. Now, you want to leave a white gap, as you want the sun to be the most brightest, and then work your way up to the yellow, as you want to create a gradient of tone, which I mentioned previously in this video. And you want to have a gradient of tone, so you add depth and contrast to this painting. And then as you work your way towards the darker colors, you want to apply a bit more color on the paper. Now, to soften these colors naturally, you want to use water to create a nice gradient of tone. Now, to get a vibrant color every time, you want to apply a bit more of the color on your palette, and then you want to press really hard on the palette to get an opaque color every time you apply it on the paper. Now, as I said, you want to have a variety of different hues and tones in your painting to add depth and contrast to your artwork. And then you want to continuously use water to softly transition the colors, so you get a gradient of tone in your artwork. Now your wet and wet layer will start to dry, so I will apply another coat of water so your colors bleed and soften as you are working on your artwork. Now, once you have done with painting the first layer of working on the sunset, you want to use a hairdryer to soften the colors out and to dry them out, and so you can work on your second layer of color. So you want to use the wet and wet technique again, applying a light coat of water on the paper and then using a darker color like the blue to get a opaque and darker color. Now, before applying the blue, you want to apply a bit of purple first, and then directly apply blue to get a darker and opaque color,
and for you to have contrast in your artwork.
Now once you're done with the sunset, then you want to use a hairdryer to dry out the colours so your trees don't blend into the sunset. Then once you're done with using the hairdryer, then we are going to move on to painting the trees. Now as I mentioned in the beginning, you want to create a straight line starting with lighter trees at the back, and then as you work your way towards the front, your trees will appear darker. Now as I said, you want to use a fan brush using straight line and horizontal strokes on the paper, and as your branch tree get larger, you want to apply a bit more strokes on the paper. Now you want to continue the process for the first set of trees, making sure that you have a generous amount of water as you want these trees to appear the lightest, and then as you work your way towards the front, your trees will appear darker and darker. Then, once you are done with painting the first row of trees, now we're going to move on to painting the second row of trees, starting with a straight line and then using horizontal strokes across the page, and then applying them using a fan brush, and then as you work your way towards the bottom, your branches will appear wider and wider. Now you will get sudden hints of black in the background as you use your fan brush, as you're going to be using this colour a lot with the fan brush. So don't worry if this does happen, you can apply another coat of water to lightly erase these colours, as with watercolour you can erase a bit of colour using water. Now this is a tip where I have for erasing watercolour, just use water to just erase your watercolour. But I would recommend that the layer is wet when using this technique, as when the water is dry, you can't really erase the watercolour. Now, once you're done with painting your second layer of trees, now we are ready to paint the front trees in the foreground. Now, these are going to be your darkest trees. Now, you want to apply the most amount of color you have, so you want to use the most amount of black in this row of trees, and you want to apply the same technique that we use throughout this artwork, starting with a sharp line and then working on your branches on top of the tree using horizontal strokes, and applying your brushes in various different sizes to get a larger branch every time you apply it on the paper.
And once you're done with painting the last row of trees, then you can apply a bit more color near the sunset to just make the colors a bit more opaque and vibrant in your artwork. Once you have completed all the trees and the sunset, now this artwork is completed. I hope you picked up lots of helpful tips and techniques for painting trees. Now I am going to be releasing another video next week. Now I hope you have a wonderful day, and as always, subscribe to the channel and turn your notification bells on so you never miss an update from me. But as always, I'll see you in my next video. Bye everybody.